Most people make the mistake of when they have an idea, they feel that, yeah, the idea is fantastic, and then next thing we need money to make this happen. And this is like a very huge mistake most people have made that has made them to actually give up on their ideas, because they feel like we don't have the resources to make this wonderful idea to come to reality. And the only thing that goes on in their mind is resources and idea, resources and idea. There are four major things which actually makes an idea to have the capacity of becoming successful. And it is going to surprise you that the idea and the money is not like the top priorities in it. So I'm going to explain them in the order of priorities, the most important to the next most important, and like that, four of them. So the first thing is timing, the timing of the idea. When is the idea getting into the market? For instance, about 10 years ago, if you bring an idea like Uber to the market, most of the people will be like, I cannot take a stranger, a complete stranger, I don't know, in my car or in my bike. Okay, because it's my personal property. I don't know what is going to happen. And when you go to countries like the United States, where people even handle guns, get license to guns anyhow, someone will tell you, I can't take this guy in an Uber because I don't know if he's going to shoot me while I'm in the car, right? So, but then a few years later, just about 5, 6, 7 years ago, Uber came into the market, and it wasn't very, very accepted by the people. It was opposed initially, but then as a result of the recession which was going on in the United States, like the ones they have not experienced in many decades, many people have to start accepting that idea, because people needed extra cash for paying their bills, for paying their children's school fees and all this stuff. So apart from their normal job, when they come back from their job in the evening, they go to ride the Uber. And the same thing happened in India. In India, they have been a little bit set back in the economy in the past 2 to 3 years. And as a result of it, companies like Uber, Ola, Rapido, these guys became very successful in the market. People started accepting these ideas, not because they were comfortable with it, but because of the situation, because of the time, because of the recession. People who were earning maybe 30,000 rupees before, their salaries got reduced to 20,000 or 25,000. And most of the people lost their jobs. And most of the people are not comfortable working from morning 9 a.m. till 6 p.m. in the evening, every day, morning, Monday to Saturday. So they decided to go into these jobs, and they use their own personal vehicles, they use their own personal bike to pick up people and make extra cash from it. The timing was very perfect. Timing is very important in every business. And the same thing applies in YouTube. The company which was there before YouTube, exactly the same business model, but at that time, the browsers which we have doesn't have these flash players which you need to stream videos online. People need to download it first and put it in their systems or in their phones before watching them. And this was like in 2001, 2002, 2003, like that. So at that time, you are not having 16 GB storage, 4 GB storage, 8 GB storage, 32, 64. No, you are having like 2 GB, 1 GB of storage. So how do you want to solve all those stuff? This company spent hundreds of millions of dollars in promotions and signing big celebrities to make content on their platform, but they lost. And in 2003, they shut down. In 2004, YouTube started, and YouTube became super successful because of the introduction of flash players from the likes of Adobe company and some other companies. So people could stream videos online. YouTube became super successful. The rest is history. I don't need to tell you. The second most important thing is the team and the execution of the idea. The team which you have to make this idea possible. I see most of entrepreneurs, most of startup founders, they want to do everything alone. And I made this big mistake when I started. So they want to make everything alone. They feel like, yeah, we have all the capabilities. Yes, you have the capabilities, but you don't have the time. You don't have all the energy to do the whole thing simultaneously. That's why you need a team. You need people who know and understand what you are doing, and it's your job to sell your vision to them, or the execution itself. Most of the ideas fail because of the way they are executed, your how. In ideas and in vision, you have your why, your how, and your what. You know what you are doing. Maybe you know why you are doing it, but how are you doing it? Are you doing it in a way that it is going to actually be successful? If it requires a mobile app and you are doing it as a website, there is a high chance that it is not going to succeed, because you are not going to reach your target market effectively. And the third thing is the business model. most of the ideas are not converted into business models before they are taken to the market. And this is the huge mistake most people make in the beginning of their business. So if you get an idea, make it into a business model. And while making it into a business model, don't stick to one model, okay? Make like 3 or 4 different models and know which one is more suitable for your market, which one is going to be more successful. And then the last and not the least thing is the resources. Most of the people think it is money that is the most important thing before you start your business. No. If these things are not in order, if the timing of the business is not there and you are not executing it properly and you are not going with the right business model, definitely you are going to invest millions and millions of dollars into that business and still it is going to fail. And there are so many businesses which failed before Airbnb came into being because those businesses came at the wrong time. There were businesses that failed before Netflix came, before Amazon Prime came, because they came at the wrong time. People were not willing to go online and pay for movies and watch them when they can actually watch it on YouTube, when they can actually go to cinemas and see those movies. But then the timing of the stuff became very important, because at those times people need to get these videos, you need to subscribe on the platforms, and then again you need to use internet, and at those times internet you are super costly. These days internets are cheap compared to 5 years ago, compared to 10 years ago. So these things we are timed perfectly and executed effectively, and this is what is making these things to actually succeed. So whenever you get a new idea, evaluate them on these priorities. These priorities, first the timing, second the team or the execution process, thirdly the business model, and finally the resources that you have, financial or material resources, and watch your business go boom maker.